Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I have measured out 1 kilogram of liquid metallic mercury. You may have seen me using some of this in some of my other videos. In fact, at one point I stuck my hand into a jar containing 20 pounds of it. And on that video, I got several comments saying, oh, that's just gallium, it's not mercury. Gallium's much less toxic and has a melting point which is low enough and it looks like mercury, so you must have used gallium because it's much less crazy to stick your hand into some gallium. What I've done is I've got the mercury here, and since some of you seem to want to see gallium, I went ahead and got some gallium. This is 1 kilogram of gallium. Now, it's not liquid. I mean, it seems pretty solid. They're both at the same temperature, and this is about 52 degrees. I don't know if you can see that, which is well below the melting point of gallium. So, before I do anything further with it, let's go ahead and put it in a pot of warm water and melt it up. Go ahead and compare the mercury to the gallium and see how different they are. Let's take my melted gallium and pour it into this glass so you can see it a little bit better. Go. Look how soupy it is. And look how sticky. It sticks to everything. Alright. That should just about be most of it. Now this plastic bag, you can see a lot of gallium stuck inside of it. So what I'm probably going to have to do is let the gallium solidify and then break the gallium pieces out to recover them. The glass, I probably just have to wash it out with acid or something. But there it is. Let's go ahead and do the same with the mercury so that we can see it in identical containers. Now the first thing you're going to notice, the mercury takes up much less space than the gallium does because it has a much higher density. In fact, gallium has about 5 grams per cubic centimeter and mercury about 13. So they have the same mass, but mercury is much smaller. Now let's go ahead and do the old trick with the bullet. This is a lead bullet with, actually this is just a solid steel bullet. Let's go ahead and drop that in there. As you can see, it floats on the mercury like a cork. All right, let's do the same with gallium. Now I don't really want to contaminate my gallium with mercury, so let's go ahead and clean this off. Okay, now let's drop the bullet into the gallium, and it drops straight to the bottom. Look at that, because steel is 7 grams per cubic centimeter, which is much denser than 5, and so it sinks. Also, you can see that the mercury really sticks to the everything.
You said mercury.
I said mercury?
Yeah.
I meant gallium. The gallium really sticks to everything. All right, let's go ahead and set these aside. We wipe it off before it solidifies. All right. Now, gallium and mercury, gallium is much less toxic than mercury, but it's still, you know, not something you want on you all the time. I mean, the shipping label clearly shows that it'll eat a hole through your hand. This is an exaggeration, but it's not perfectly safe. Mercury certainly isn't safe either. There's probably no point in wearing gloves because I'm going to take one off now. Let's go ahead and show you what happens when I stick my finger into the gallium. Now, gallium is much less dense, and so it takes a lot less work for me to get my finger into it. And as you can see, when I pull it out, it's covered with gallium bits. It's very messy in comparison to sticking my finger into the mercury. In fact, let's go ahead and do that now just for kicks. See, yeah. It comes out much cleaner than the gallium, even though the mercury's got some crud on it. All right, so there you go. Gallium versus mercury. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.